magic world of steps and lakes. These have their unique images, profiles, colors, ornaments, unique flora and fauna, as well as amazing birds. Here on the windswept steppe of the Kurgaljin Nature Reserve, the wetland's exceptional nature manifests itself. In this vastness, one can easily get lost among numerous steppe roads stretching in every direction. They run as the wind moves, to the north, to the west, to the south, and to the east. Our road runs ahead along the plain steppe, yellow and dusty, where the grass covers the steppe touches the sky. It seems that the dry plain is endless. The indescribable beauty of the blue skies enhances all the colors there. For thousands of years, the same feather grass has been lulling the silence of legends which found eternal rest here a long time ago. And the wind again and again blasts and storms the steppe. There are no barriers here where the wind reigns supreme. Born in the depth of Great Asia, the winds are tuning their songs. These melodies are eternal and shroud the vast outback land, the cradle of the primordial. Looking at the bird hovering in the sky, you understand that it can see all the magnificent reach of the steppe. Picturesque views open up from the bird's eye view. And all this is the realm of protected land, the habitat of red-listed animals and birds. For millions of years, ancient unique lakes and steppes slumber here under the covers of clouds. And a bird sheltered by the veil of clouds from the sun's scorching rays, the beauty and the queen of the heaven, shows us the way here to the protected land. The pearl of sovereign Kazakhstan, Kurgaljin State Nature Reserve, is located here in the southwest part of the Tengiz-Kurgaljin Depression. If we look at the map, we'll see this unique corner of the earth in the very heart of Kazakhstan. This is the largest protected area in the country. It is located 160 kilometers northwest of the national capital Astana. Its total area is 543.171 hectares. The Tengiz-Kurgaljin Depression is located at the junction of steppe and semi-desert zones, separating the Kazakh small hills from the Kokshetau elevation. The climate here is strongly continental. It is characterized by aridness and sharp ambient temperature fluctuations during a year, a month, and even a day. Average ambient temperature in July is 22 degrees above 0 Celsius. In January, it is 12 degrees below 0 Celsius. Autumn and spring are short, whereas winter is lasting. Cold with steady snow cover, considerable wind speed, and quite frequent snowstorms. Warm seasons are characterized by low precipitation, relatively high temperatures, and dryness of air. So what is it like, the remote past and worthy present of the Kurgaljin State Nature Reserve? The lakes and rivers have always given to a traveler fish and game, fuel for fire, and shelter in bad weather. The Kurgaljin lakes save people and cattle from starvation during the years of great deprivation and famine. The steppe tale of amicable nomadic settlements was told for centuries. The history of the nature reserve itself started in the times of massive development of virgin fallow land of northern and central Kazakhstan, when it became an urgent need to maintain some areas of the steppe zone untouched. The reorganization of the reserve took years. And only on the 18th of April in 1968, the forestry and game husbandry operating here was reorganized into the Kurgaljin State Nature Reserve, or Zapovednik, by the resolution of the Council of Ministers of KAZ SSR. But the process of establishing the nature reserve lasted up until 1976. By that time, the enterprises which used to operate there were completely wound up. Some settlements and livestock facilities were relocated, and most importantly, the borders of the protected zone were fixed. Today, the Tengiz-Kurgaljin lakes are not only the largest water area, but one of the most unique areas throughout the Eurasian continent. Two important world flyways cross here. The largest in Asia population of waterfowl, consisting of 112 species, has chosen the reserve as its habitat. At one time, there may be as many as 350,000 nesting birds gathered here. Twice a year, migratory birds have the longest stop at the bodies of water, attracted by the vast, accessible, rich food available there. It is not an accident that in 1974 the Tennessee Kurgeljin Lakes was accepted as a Ramsar site under the Ramsar Convention on Wetlands of International Importance, especially as waterfowl habitat. In 2000, the Tennessee Lake was included in the Living Lakes Network, which includes the most unique lakes of the world. In 2008, the Kurgeljin Lake was included in UNESCO World Natural Heritage. The Kurgeljin Nature Reserve is also a member of important bird areas. The waves of feather grass and the smell of wormwood are world rich in animals and birds. This is what enlivens the endless steppe reaches. Nature speaks to us through their voices, in the language of sounds and colors. 42 mammal species, 339 bird species, 4 vermigrade species, 2 amphibian species, and 14 fish species are registered here. There are more than 300 species of various higher plants, 40% of which is composite, cereals, and goose food. Half of these plants are typical steppe plants. There are no trees here, but there are 12 different bushes, such as willow, dog rose, honeysuckle, which mainly grow near the river bottomlands. You can also find here a special group of plants that adapted themselves to grow in saline soil. These include saltwort, Halosnemnum strobilesum, sipweed, marsh beet, different species of glasswort and nitraria. The Kurgeljin Nature Reserve has registered 45 species of rare and endemic plants that are under special protection. Among these is the red-listed Schrenki tulip, a beautiful plant when it stands alone. But when you see a whole field of tulips, the sight is so thrilling and breathtaking that you can stop admiring it. With these new amazing colors, the whole steppe transforms. To be able to see it all, you have to go farther into the steppe, a large area full of miracles. Here and there you can see various traces left by the local inhabitants. Saigai is not a rare guest here, but it's difficult to see it in these places, as it is a very timid animal, wary of slightest rustle. The pristine nature gives birth to infinite miraculous and fantastic landscapes on this land. You can find yourself in a place where you expect to see just a bare valley, but as you move further on, the landscape suddenly makes a transformation into a luminous lake or a flooded valley of marsh. The Kurgeljin Lake is a kingdom of reed and mace reed. The reed beds take 70-80% of the water level. The reeds divide the lake into several large gulfs and reaches, each making a separate lake. Each lake has its own face and its own music and colors of deep waves that exposes to you with every step you make in this nature reserve. Lakes are full of turquoise water, which looks like a welcome of a generous host, with full dishes. They are beautiful and mysterious. One of the most beautiful places is the Tennessee Lake, a marvelous creation of the nature reserve full of ancient legends. One of the legends says, that the mother river Sererka had two children, a quiet and reserved son Ishim, and a restless beautiful daughter Nura. One day the mother said to her children,
"My children, I heard that your grandfather, the old Tengiz, is drying out. His shores are covered with dead salt and the bird stops nesting and singing there. It's very quiet there now. Go and fill it with your fresh and young water."
So Ishim and Nura ran to the west, where a large and proud Tengiz lies among the small hills. And on its way, Ishim turned to the north, and only gentle Nura, following its mother's request, went on to help its grandfather. A wicked genie blocked its way and kept Nura a captive. While Nura was waiting in captivity, it flooded into a large fresh Kurgeljin Lake. Nevertheless, the bright Nora was able to cheat the wicked genie and freed itself from captivity. It met with Tanis, bringing a new life to its dry shores. This might be just a beautiful legend, but it has a deep meaning. Mother Nature, with its inherent generosity, has presented man with a real miracle. A wise and reserved lake full of inconceivable miracles. Birds like the Tanis Lake for its big space and plenty of food, but mainly for its gentle and often swampy shores, which protect them from people and predators. The area of the Tanis water level is 1.599 square kilometers, and its shoreline is 488 kilometers long. This huge closed lake with bitter and salty water is the 12th largest lake in the CIS and lies at the periphery of the Kazakh plateau among the rough and hilly virgin land with its tilled and pristine areas. The colors of the sky are reflected in the lake water, mirroring the birds in flight. There are birds whose singing finds a way to some special feelings in our hearts. Demoiselle, one such bird, can live only in open spaces. It is real bliss to watch birds in wild nature without disturbing them. Today it seems that the danger to this bird is gone, although there are no data on the exact number of these birds. The demoiselle now frequently builds a nest in the local steppe areas. The most attractive part of this bird is its head, attired with a light hat and two bunches of white feather on the back of its head. The impression is that it is dressed in a silk attire decorated with fringes and brushes of feather grass. Total, the Kurgaljin Nature Reserve has 37 Kazakhstan Red Book birds, 20 of which are included into the World Red Book. Just like a thirsty traveler would keep water on his palm on the way to his dry lips, the steppe keeps the Tanis Lake with its pearls-like shiny water. Spacious areas, lake shores, river bushes, all these revive when summer comes. In the calm early morning, birds start to sing serenades which fall from the blue sky like silver ring chimes. From time to time, the chorus and tunes are joined with the voices of ground squirrels standing stiff beside their shadow-lit burrows. In the open space, they present a potential victim to birds of prey. And everywhere on the edges, you can see muddy gray creeping stems of pond grass. There are a lot of fish and other water inhabitants in the lake, which explains the multitude of birds here. You can always see white and gray herons at the fishing post as you approach the shore. They build their nest colonies far away at the osier beds. The voices of great reed rubber can be heard in the withered reeds and windy tangles. A silent muskrat swims by in a businesslike manner. Once it disappears in the bushes, the quiet life of the lake is restored. Birds from northern and central Kazakhstan and western and eastern Siberia fly to this area for their summer change of coat. Walking by the lake along its shore, bushes disturb clouds of green insects. If you take a closer look, you can see that the grass is fully covered with light-winged mosquitoes. Dragonflies fly over the water, displaying their excellent mobility. You can see ants, grasshoppers, and spiders on the grass, and butterflies and bees in the air. Without these insects, the life of numerous flowers is impossible. The insects are also food for many wild animals, reptiles, and birds. At sunset, the steppe returns to life, and with the arrival of dusk, you seem to be lost in the history of this small planet. Summer is a special period for birds when they look after their litter. But before this, they have their collective wedding parties. Flamingos' breeding colonies might have up to 10,000 couples. The places of nesting and wintering can be scattered around within 1,000 kilometers from each other. Membranous feet enable flamingos to walk on both the slippery, oozy ground and firm ground. Pink flamingos catch their food, small crayfish, shell and worms, digging them from the silt under the water. In general, flamingos live about 30 years. If you have a chance to look at the colony of flamingos from the air, you would think that the lake is covered with pink petals. There are numerous legends devoted to this bird. One of the legends tells about a generous flamingo bird which saved people's life in a lean year. That flamingo helped the people to survive sacrificing its own life. Its blood was dropping along the feather, making them pink. In memory of that flamingo, all flamingos have pink tinted feathers. Flamingos, when they fly, can disappear from sight so quickly that you can lose the feeling of reality, and only their specific honk proves that they were real. Out of 6 existing species of flamingos, only 2 inhabit the Tanais Lake, namely the rose-eared flamingo or greater flamingo. In the midsummer, when the sun is in its full prime, the grass starts to yellow to be able to revive again. Days pass by. Old grass and plants are replaced with new ones. Small beetles fly away from one bush to another, from one blade to another. Summer is over and gives way to autumn. It is a grand but at the same time sad season. Birds fly away to warm countries. They abandon their nests with the first signs of winter when the days become shorter and colder. Much depends on the weather. On the date of travel, the day should be mild and stable. Of course, some birds do not make it and die, but most survive. This seasonal migration helped birds to survive as a biological form. To be able to make the trip, birds should be healthy and have a sufficient fat layer and new feathering. You can hear sad clanging of cranes, as if they are inviting you to fly with them. Swift and resonant swallows will soon stop their flying. Small and large flocks of geese, swans and ducks set on their way to the south. While the life on the lakes is still active, as the last birds will fly away only with the first snow, the steppe is already cheerless and empty. This is late autumn with its first snow. Winter covers the cold earth with a warm and fluffy coat. Everywhere you look, you can only see snow and you can only hear silence. But the silence in the steppe is deceitful. Take a closer look and you'll see that life is in full swing. Either a hare jumps out of the wild grass, or a fox in a red fur coat, or a bird of prey sneaks around looking for prey, or an ermine starts a white winter attire. It is a wolf who is the smartest, resourceful, and probably the strongest animal among the beasts of prey. In winter, wolves' main food is wild boar. The male